I want to first of all get your maybe an update on how the market has reacted to the inflation number down to 11.7% in August. Many people called it a surprise. How have bonds yields reacted to this?
Well, over the weekend when we saw the numbers, the natural expectation was that there was going to be some form of rally downwards because that was about 110 basis point movement. Even though the bond had already rallied before the inflation numbers, we still expected to see some slight movement in the yields downward. Yeah. But what happened yesterday in the market was that the market was just very flat. We saw 1 to 2 basis point movement across the curve, which was not a natural reaction to such a huge basis point movement in the inflation numbers. But I think what the fact that the market had priced a lot of movement before the announcement itself was one of the reasons why we didn't see much movement.
So clearly the market has moved significantly and moved probably 300, 400 basis points over the last few weeks. But your thoughts on the expectation for inflation, because I did see a note from Samuel Ocheho at Standard Bank giving us a view that he sees single-digit inflation by October. Now, if we did see that, do you think that yields could come down from where they are right now?
The truth is that there's still room for yields to go southward. If you look at the inflation numbers that have been projected from economists all over, not just the Standard Bank economists, we've seen the projection from Stanchard, from Renkab, from other economists. And I think by the end of the year, we should see single digit into 2013. The Standard Bank economy has said by October, single digit is expected. But if we look at the trend, I think single digit is not far. We might just see it in the October numbers.
And that do you think we could see single digit bond yields though?
In bond yield, there's nothing stopping it from getting to single digit. What investors want to see is really a real returns. If the inflation numbers move further to single digit, there's nothing stopping the bond yields from getting there, especially with the kind of interest we are seeing in the market.
If those interest, very strong interest, as you were just noting that. But let's move on quickly to the MPC. I just want to get your thoughts on this. It's widely expected that we would see yield, the benchmark rate at 12% unchanged. But we could see the central bank decide to tweak the standard lending facility or the standard deposit rate, which of course a premium or are all centered around the 12% rate right now. Your thoughts on what impact that could have? Or in fact, maybe I can start by getting your thoughts. Do you think that is likely, even if we see the 12% unchanged?
I don't think it is likely that they move the band. I don't see any reason why they want to do that. We saw the tightening measures embarked upon at the last MPC meeting. I guess the effect so far has been in the right direction where the central bank wants it. The Naira has gotten stronger. The demand on the central bank window is very low. So the central bank is happy that the measures they've put in place is working. I don't see any reason why they want to destabilize the policy at this time by tweaking the band. My own expectation for the MPC result is that it is going to remain unchanged across all fronts.
Okay, any move on the currency though? You just noted that it's been very strong since the last MPC. Do you think they may make a move? Any move around the exchange rate?
Well, I don't think they're going to change the band anymore, and I don't expect them at this auction to increase at this MPC to increase the NOP numbers. But what I think is that because of the strong interest we're seeing in the market, the listing of the Nigerian bonds in the October 1, the JP Morgan Index, yeah, the auction of this week, well, I think you're still going to see some foreign interest into the market. And if those interest comes in, then it should make the Naira get more stronger. So if you ask me on a short-term basis, I see it hovering about the lows of 157. And if the interest continues, it might break the 157 band into 156.
Well, clearly, the picture is very positive for the Naira these days. And we'll see how things play out today. Thank you so much, Sam, for joining us. We look forward to speaking to you again.